Hey, my name is Ed Aboyi, and welcome to the channel. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button, and if at some point while you're watching this video you find something useful or helpful to you, pause the video, hit the like button and return and start watching. Okay, with that said, let's get to the business of the day. Now create the file. We're using 3000 for the height because we're multiplying the 1000 by 3 to have 3 panels for a simple comic strip. So we'll change the color to black now and use a box to create the outlines between all of the panels that we'll have. Now we'll pick not that one. Yep, that one. And move it around. Try to center it as much as possible. Let's take it up to make room for the other panels that we'll create later on. Scale that a bit, I guess. So just the size is perfect. Well, good enough. Okay. Yeah, I think that almost does it. Alright, so we'll duplicate this layer a couple of times and drag them one by one to their appropriate positions. Drag that down. Yeah, so it's basically just all about placing, trying to get it in the right position or your preferred position. Okay. Now see, there's not enough room for the last one, so we'll go back again to the second panel and drag it up. Alright, let's keep adjusting. You can also be tapping the arrow keys to move up and down, left and right, to ensure all those little movements and positioning are proper. Alright, this is okay. We are done with the arrangement of the panels, and let's move on to something else. Can try to rename or name your panels as well for clarity. That's very useful when you're drawing so you don't get mixed up. Okay, now you use the fill tool to try to add the fill to our panels created. Okay. So let's hide it and check which panel it is. That's actually supposed to be number 3, not number 2. Alright, so let's make it 3 instead. You can feel that. You want to make sure you're filling on the right panel. So confirm that from the layers panel and beside the layers window. Yeah, that's done with the fill. Okay, let's do something else. Go ahead and group these 3 layers then. Okay, let's hit Ctrl G to create a group quickly. And then we're going to create another kind of special group again within this group. Okay, let's select them again. And this time around, right click and go to group and quick clipping group. What this does is to help to ensure that your drawing doesn't show outside of the panel. And let me change that brush to black so you can see what I'm talking about. See that the space in between the panels doesn't contain any drawing, so that even when you're drawing and it bleeds out, it will still be cool. It will show up in the empty spaces, the white spaces. So I'll call this layer drawing. Actually call it drawing 1 or panel 1. Okay, once again we'll duplicate these layers a couple of times. Name this one drawing 2. Don't worry about the spelling, we'll fix that in the future. Make another copy again, call this one drawing 3. Hit enter. Now let's fix that spelling. It's a little G missing there. Alright. Now let's balance the word again. Okay, so name this one drawing 1. Alright. Go ahead, start drawing on your panels if you wish. But then this is actually me showing you how to create a template that you can use over and over. So you want to include your logo in that template so that you don't have to go through the pains of putting a logo for every time you are designing a comic. So it's really useful if you add that logo by creating a file layer. Okay, I'll call that layer brand and then move it up above all the other layers. Just make sure it shows. And now you see I can't transform unless I convert to paint layer. Scale that down. Make sure you're holding shift. You should always hold shift when you're scaling something down unless you want to change the form. No one really does anyway. Okay, now click. That placement is fine, so let's copy and move that down. Okay, use this too. Okay, copy here. And let's drag it to the last panel. So anything, any information you want to add, you can add it now to all the panels. So it shows up every time you're creating a comic, since this is a template they're designing. Then we put all of that in a group and call it brand so we can hide or move or work with it easily. And also name this other group drawing or draw. Alright. So I actually forgot. Okay, now let me show you something else. You can still make an additional layer. G. Let's duplicate. And then I'll call this layer painting. Because you might want to add colors to your comic strip at some point. It's not completely necessary, but if you wish to, you can have a paint layer. And also a sketch layer. Just in case you're finding it hard to draw something, you can just make a sketch and then hide the layer when you're done. Now you can go ahead and see your templates. So let's pick a folder, save the templates. Let's give this template a name. Comic strip templates. Krita tutorial. See. Alright. So I advise you to also save it in the PSD format. So maybe someday in the future you want to work with even Photoshop as well. You see that Krita saves files in Photoshop format for you also. Okay. So yeah, here's something I forgot. Before you work with your template, once you open it, make sure you give it a name, go to save as, and give it a new name so it doesn't, everything you do won't affect the actual template. The template should always remain as it is. So let's go and let's save this as a cra.cry creator file. And then I will change the name to the name of the comic we are actually working on. This is very, very important so you don't have to bring your template. So we'll just call this comic. Please subscribe and get the joke when you get back to the video, the rest part of the video. Okay, now yeah, all cut up, so let's get back to the video. Great. Okay, here we are now. Let's try to draw a comic. Go to our draw, go to panel. Okay, drawing 1, go to panel 1 drawings, and let's zoom in. Try to create a circle. The head of a character. just going to test out the beads here. So I get the right brush settings. This brush size is too big. So let's adjust. Now this is too big. And adjust the brush size from up there. Let's just keep trying until we arrive at the size that is almost perfect for us. Yeah, I think 11.22 does it. It's cool, it's fine. So let's draw a circle. Yep. Awesome. And draw another circle again. Bear in mind I'm holding down shift to make sure this circle is perfect. Oh, draw some circles for the eyes. You can also use circles to draw the eyeball. But I don't really like it. I'm using my pen tool to draw the eyeball. So, alright, let's use that pen tool. You can see. I'm using the mouse here, so drawing that line straight won't really work well for us. So let's change the smoothing and make it weighted and adjust that's this. Now you see that the drawing is a lot more, it's clean, the lines are cleaner, it's easier to draw now with the mouse. Actually, making this tutorial, I normally don't draw the mouse, but I found out that drawing the mouse in Krita, a comic strip in Krita with a mouse, is actually possible. That's actually possible. So yeah, I guess that takes the excuse of not having the tablet off the table if you have Krita installed. So for the eyebrows, let me increase the brush size a bit. So we just use one stroke to create the eyebrows. There, perfect. Alright, so take it back to our 11. And now let's draw some lines for the neck. Let's make the body. Drawing in digital art, you always have to hit undo a lot till you get something perfect. Ctrl Z, that's not good enough. Okay, this is alright. This line is actually very, very clean considering I'm using the mouse. It's really good. So let's do a straight line for the shirts. And just one line body. Alright, another line. Instead, I'll just draw another for the hand as well. Okay, and then we have our character all drawn. That's really cute. Okay, let's try to drag and also move the character around. Since it's the only object we have drawn, we don't need to select before we drag it. Now you can see where we created the clipping layer mask initially. Okay, let's try to add some text, some speech. Alright, create a new layer, call that speech. This will just be for the speech bubble, bear in mind. Now let's go to our brush and let's try to make a speed bubble. For me, I just create something simple for my speed bubble. Just a line like that pointing to the character talking. And you can decide to use your free hand to draw, to write the text, but man, not me. So let's go to the text tool. Now let's type out what the character will be saying. Hey, I hope you found this helpful. So then subscribe and share. Please, it's a question. Do subscribe and share the video. Let's get people watching. That'll be cool. So now it's time to choose the fonts. But I could search the font there, but it didn't really work out that way. Maybe I figured that out some other time. Yeah, and I actually have a font called comic book here. Two comic book fonts actually. So just work with that. You can choose the size, and you see it's when replies until you hit save. Now let's drag that aside, and yeah, takes effect. It's too small now. Let's increase the size. Let's try 18. Still not big enough. Let's try a different size. Drag down 72. Wow, we're going big this time. Still too big, bigger than even a speed bubble. Okay, yeah, I think this does it. This is okay. It's great. And yeah, that's well placed. Okay, we're done with the drawing. We've created a panel. You can create other panels following the same method. So you are done with your story. Always plan your story before starting, by the way. Now let's go on and export this video. Now I'm exporting it to a JPEG. Let's export to a JPEG. Alright, so hit save. You can choose the quality from here, go all the way to 100 and hit OK. And there you are done with the export. And that covers it for this tutorial. I'd like to see you again some other time. So, bye bye.